So now we're going to look real briefly at what we do in a more complicated reaction where there's more than one reactant. Okay? And so what we do for the integrated rate laws, the kinetics. So let's look at this one that we've seen before. The reaction of bromate ion with bromide and hydrogen ion to make liquid bromine and water. What we do, okay, so that's going to be a pretty complicated rate law involving all these three the reactants, complicated reaction. So what we do is we pick one of those. Okay, we're setting up the experiment, so we can do what we want, right? So we make the concentration of one of them a lot smaller than the other. So let's say we pick bromate and make its initial concentration 1 times 10 to the minus 3 molar. And we set the initial concentration of bromide and hydrogen ion to 1,000 times bigger, like at that one molar, all right? So that means that as this reaction happens, compared to the concentration of bromate, the concentration of bromide and hydrogen ion are not going to change appreciably. So we can say that over the course of this reaction, the concentration of hydrogen ion and bromide pretty much stay the same. Okay, so we say, okay, it doesn't change. It's constant. Now, if the concentrations are constant, when we look at the form of the rate law, so the rate's going to be K, concentration of bromide, concentration of hydrogen ion squared, concentration of bromate. This, well, we looked at how we got this experimentally. This had to be determined experimentally, but that's the rate law. But if we keep these two concentrations the same pretty much throughout the reaction by making their initial concentration so much larger than the concentration of bromate, we can just say that they're constant and pull them into the rate constant K, call it K prime. So now we have the rate is equal to K prime times the concentration of bromate, okay? Where K prime, it's just the real rate constant times the initial concentration of bromide times hydrogen ion squared. And so now what we have is a first order rate law. Well, we call it pseudo first order because we had to force it to be that way by playing with the initial concentrations, but it is. So if we were to plot the natural log of the concentration of bromate versus time for this reaction, for this experiment, we would get a straight line. So what we can do is, okay, we can do our normal experiment, or do our normal kinetics, and find the K prime, our rate constant for this pseudo first order reaction. But once we know that, okay, we can rearrange this equation, solve it for the real rate constant, okay, because we know what the initial concentrations of these are, plug them in, and we now know what the rate constant is for the overall reaction, regardless of the initial concentrations.